everyone, welcome to AeroHub. Today I'll be talking about aircraft propulsion, how thrust is produced, what are the different kinds of engines used. Okay, so let's get started. Introduction. We know that thrust is produced by engines. Engine is the one that drives an aircraft forward. These are air breathing engines. They require air as a fluid to produce thrust or to propel an aircraft forward. Propulsion means the action of driving or pushing forward. Jet propulsion is used in most of the modern aircraft today. Most of the engines are either run by piston engine or a gas turbine engine. So this here, this is a piston propeller engine and this is gas turbine engine. These engines discharge a fast moving jet which generates thrust in accordance with Newton's laws of motion. Classification of power plant. Reciprocating engine. We have petrol engine, diesel engine, gas turbine engine, turbojet, turboprop, turbofan, turboshaft, ramjet and scramjet. So we will understand one by one. Piston engine. Piston engine or a reciprocating engine is typically a heat engine that uses one or more reciprocating pistons to convert pressure into a rotating motion. So this, we can see here, this is an engine. These are the parts of piston engine. This is the piston. This is the connecting rod and this is crankshaft. This is inlet valve and outlet valve. This is a spark plug. In case of a petrol engine, we will have a spark plug. And for the diesel engine, we'll have a fuel injector. So this is a working of the piston engine. So let's understand how it works. So piston engine has four strokes and it works on auto cycle. First stroke is an inlet stroke. So the first stroke is an inlet stroke, where air enters through the inlet valve, piston moves down. So the second stroke is a compression stroke, where piston moves up, inlet valve and the exit valve remains closed, piston moves up and the air gets compressed. So the third stroke is a combustion stroke, where fuel air mixture is ignited by spark plug. The fourth stroke, the final stroke, that is the exhaust stroke, where the burn gases will exit from the exhaust valve. Here, the burn gases will exit from the exhaust valve. The crankshaft here, the crankshaft transforms the reciprocating motion of the piston into the rotary motion. In turn, the propeller will be rotated and an aircraft will move forward. So this is a typical piston propeller engine, and this configuration here, this arrangement is the radial arrangement, and we'll see the different types of arrangement. So here are the different types of arrangement of an engine. So this is a inline vertical engine where all the engines are in vertical inline. This is V type. Engines are placed in a V shape. This is horizontal engine. They're horizontal to one another. This is opposed cylinder engine. They're opposite to each other. They place opposite to each other. This is W type. And this is radial engine, where cylinders are placed in a radial manner. Now, next is gas turbine engine. Non-reciprocating aircraft engines or gas turbine engines, all of which operate on the principle of Newton's third law. So Newton's third law says that for every action, there's equal and opposite reaction. A gas or working fluid is accelerated by the engine, and the reaction to this acceleration produces a force, generates thrust and pushes the aircraft to move in forward direction. So the thrust produced in the engine is responsible for the aircraft to move in the forward direction. And the equation for thrust is T is equal to m dot into V2 minus V1, where m dot is the mass flow rate, which is m by T, V2 is the velocity of the exit air, and V1 is the velocity of the inlet air. And thrust here is a force. It is in Newton. Major components of gas turbine engines. There are five major components of a gas turbine engine. That is inlet, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and nozzle. So we'll understand one by one what are the functions of these each individual component. The air enters the intake of the engine. Intake ensures smooth airflow, which then gets compressed in the compressor. This increases the pressure and velocity, thereby decreases. Once the air gets compressed, the air fuel mixture is burned in the combustion chamber. Aviation gasoline is used. The burned gases are then expanded in the turbine. The function of a turbine is to drive the compressor and engine accessories. Kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy. So in a typical jet engine, about 75% of the power produced internally is used to drive the compressor, and the remaining power is used to produce thrust. The exhaust duct or nozzle takes the relatively high pressure and low velocity gas leaving the turbine and accelerates this gas flow to higher speeds. This is how a gas turbine engine works, and they work on Brayton cycle. So if you have to compare piston engine and gas turbine engine, in gas turbine engine all the events takes place simultaneously. However, in a reciprocating engine, each event follows the preceding event. Gas turbine engines operates at higher speeds. Noise and vibration is greater in piston engine compared to the gas turbine engine. Okay, so let's see one by one the different types of engines used. Turbojet engine. Frank Whittle submitted his first patent for a turbojet engine in 1930. And these type of engines were also used in World War II. The turbojet is an air-breathing jet engine used in aircraft. It consists of a gas turbine with a propelling nozzle. Air-breathing engine is the one which requires air to produce the thrust, whereas rocket engines are called non-breathing engines as it carries oxygen with it. So it works with the working fluid, consists of inlet, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, nozzle. So it works basically same as a gas turbine, and the efficiency of this turbojet engine is good at higher speeds. The compressed air will have pressure far more greater than the atmospheric pressure. Modern jet engines have 30:1 ratio, that is 30 times more pressure will be increased in the compressor. Okay, next we have turboprop. A turboprop engine is a turbine engine that drives an aircraft propeller. So a turboprop engine is a turbojet engine with a propeller here. In contrast to a turbojet, the engine's exhaust gases do not contain enough energy to create significant thrust, since almost all the engine's power is used to drive the propeller. So almost 80% of the power is used by the propeller, and only 10-20% comes out as the exhaust gas or as a thrust. So this is a gearbox, reduction gearbox we call. It is used to control the speed of the propeller. Turboprop engines provide efficient power at lower speeds. Hence, they are used for low-speed aircraft. With the increase in the altitude, thrust decreases as the density of air decreases. Turbofan engine. A turbofan engine is a large fan at the front which sucks in air. So a turbofan engine is basically a jet engine which has a fan in the frontal part, and also there is a bypass. So this is actual engine and this is the bypass. So most of the air flows around the outside of the engine. So this is the core and this is outside of the engine. It makes it quieter and gives more thrust at low speeds. Most of the today's aircrafts are powered by turbofans. This is called as bypass, and the bypass ratio is the airflow outside the engine to the airflow to the core. So bypass ratio will always be high. Turbofan generates more thrust for nearly the same amount of fuel used by the core. Turbofan is fuel efficient, can operate at higher speeds. So they are very much fuel efficient and they produce more thrust at the same fuel intake. Next we have turboshaft. A turboshaft engine is a gas turbine that is optimized to produce shaft power rather than jet thrust. So this turboshaft, it has a shaft here. It produces the shaft power rather than the jet thrust. So these turboshaft engines are used in helicopters. The primary difference here is the turboshaft and the turbojet is that an additional power section consisting of turbines and an output shaft has been incorporated into the design. Here an additional additional shaft and turbine has been incorporated, and these kind of engines are used in the helicopter. So next we have ramjet and scramjet engines. These are the simplest types of all the jet engines because it has no moving parts. These are the simplest types because they don't have any moving parts. So the diffusers, the inlet, they convert the kinetic energy of the entering air into the pressure energy and thereby into the pressure rays and thereby increasing the pressure. This energy transformation is called ram effect. The sharp edge here acts as a diffuser and flow gets further compressed inside. Shock waves are generated to compress the air and they reach the combustion chamber where fuel and air is mixed and ignited and exits through converging nozzle and exits through the nozzle, and it will usually be greater than the Mach number will usually be greater than 1. So we have seen what is Mach number. It is the ratio of velocity of an object to the velocity of sound. So if Mach number is greater than 1, that means the speed is greater than the speed of sound. So the exhaust gases will have the engine at higher velocity around Mach 4 to 5. This is the ramjet, and here this is the scramjet. Scramjet is similar to ramjet. Ramjet, in case of ramjet, it deaccelerates the air to subsonic velocity. So in ramjet, it deaccelerates the air to subsonic velocities before reaching the combustion chamber. While in scramjet, it will remain supersonic throughout the engine. This allows the scramjet to operate efficiently at extremely high speeds. The exhaust gases will leave the engine at higher velocities around Mach 6 to 8. So these kind of engines are used in space launch vehicles, supersonic missiles. Location of engines. So they are usually placed at the nose, frontal area, in the fuselage, and they are submerged in the wing here and rear mounted. These are the locations of engine, and based on the number of engines, they can be a single engine, double engine, or it can be multi engines as well. So here we can see we have a multi engine here. This is a two engine, and we can have one engine also, we can have three engines also. So yes, so this is all about today's session. Thank you so much.